When we kind of roll out the walk-a-thon to the students every 3 years, we really talk to them about how it's an opportunity to show empathy and to make connections with the community and the world as a whole. It's almost like a rite of passage that the kids get to experience in middle school, and a lot of the times when the kids come back, they talk about like, oh, this is what we did and we raised this much money, and they can remember how much they raised.
My sister was here in eighth grade when her walk-a-thon year was here, and I remember when I was little and she was telling me all about it, I was like, that's something I want to be a part of because it can make a difference in like our community. So now coming in and having this experience where we can try to make our school and our community and other parts of the world a better place, it's like a really special opportunity.
Not all cities or like states or like even countries can like even have this opportunity to gather all this money and everything and donate it.
Trying to like set a campaign for this was kind of...
It was difficult.
Yeah, it was difficult. Yeah. When we all picked Alex's underage scene, I felt like kind of bad because my own cousin had stage 4 and he died when I was 7 and he was like 10. So I just had a kind of a hard time doing this campaign, but overall I think we all did good.
We kind of felt bad for like Alex's like parents and stuff. So we were excited on the way through to like help find like a cure for cancer.
To help pursue Alex's dream.
So then like other moms and dads don't have to feel the same that Alex's parents did. Something that I've learned from this experience is to never give up.
Many of these kids, they're fighting for their life and they can't give up.
We like take things for granted like every day. I feel like we don't really understand until we walk in their shoes.
We get the opportunity to do this thing that will help benefit so many people.
We're a lot more privileged than we think, and there's a lot more kids that need help than you really see.
I think what's really cool about this event is that students, and a lot of them for the first time, are learning what it's like to be part of a huge effort to give back as a community to some sort of cause that supports the needs of children. They see the bigger impact that they're having, the bigger cause that an entire school community can come together and work towards one purpose. So bringing those classroom skills into real life situations where they can actually have an impact is huge. They're taking ownership of this process, and I think it builds confidence and independence in our students.
In terms of the skills, they really get to put it to work. You know, they're using the research, they're understanding about, you know, how our government and voting works, and they're able to make those real life connections that they'll take with them. Just seeing the kids on that last day where they're all having a great time and they're really getting that, yes, we did something great, but they're having fun doing it, which is awesome, because then that's going to make them want to continue to do those types of things. When it really comes together and they see that, they're really in awe of what they were able to do.
Well, what you did today and what you've been doing to help other people is probably the best thing that you can do in life. So thank you for doing this. Give yourselves another round of applause. That's great work.